We've been through some of your equipment, the guitar, what's on the floor, and the amps as well. We haven't actually talked about your plectrums. Are we using something with turbocharge or something?
No, it must be that way. It's an ongoing thing for me, picks. I'm yet to settle on one for longer than 6 months. The longest period I had was from January to about yesterday. I've got these like Dava picks. They're like sort of jazz threes. I use them like in the band and stuff because they're really good for riffing, and they don't get caught up in the string. That's the problem I get.
What are you using today?
Is just a regular Dunlop Point 73.
73, yeah.
Which again, it's kind of weird, you know.
It sounds light for a sort of, excuse me, you can call you a shredder, but you know, for the shredding stuff you're doing, 73 would, you know, I'd expect you to use a 1.5, maybe 2 even, so
well,
I'm surprised
yeah,
that you
the,
can.
The thing is, I like picks with give in because, I mean, if you look at Paul Gilbert, he uses like 0.60
mil. Okay, I wasn't aware of that.
He never used to, but I think he kind of, because he's known for that sort of machine gun like picking. You know, when you've got like a bit of give in your pick, you can really slap it through the string.
Yeah.
And that's what gives you that.
Well, do you lower the pick further into
the
string, as it were, to give it more of a.
The pick. Like, I mean, if you sort of. So it just allows you a bit more freedom through the string.
Are you hitting the string straight on with the plectrum, or is it angled at all?
No, it's kind of like an angle. But it sort of bends funny, like through the string. I mean, you can flatten the pick out a little bit if you want more of that. If you want more attack.
And how are you holding? Is it just the index finger, or is it doing with your
It's just like
index
side of my finger.
It is straight wrapped over the top like that.
Just like that, yeah. So it's basically sort of side on. Your thumb is literally parallel with the string, and then your first finger is sort of folded under your thumb.
Yeah.
And then it just slots in there. So, I mean, I do use like some smaller picks and stuff, but I always find that I don't feel like I'm grabbing hold of enough plastic pushing it through the guitar, so I've always struggled with like jazz threes and stuff like that, you know. Even though they can be more accurate, I mean, when I'm recording I use like loads of different picks just depending on the sort of lick I'm playing or whatever, you know. But the thing is, it's really hard to find one pick that will do everything.
Yeah.
But then having said that, maybe it's just a technique thing, you know. Maybe I should just literally pick one pick and go right.
that's it.
I'm going to make everything work with that one thing, but I kind of never have, really.
No.
Until I started discovering other picks. I think before then, I was probably just using standard 1mm Tortex, like for years, you know. Or Gibson ones, Gibson hard Gibson ones or something like that. Just anything I could find in a music shop, really.
That's amazing.
Yeah, because there's so much choice now with picks, it really is hard, especially for people that they don't really know what they should be using, because so many people use different things.